Department of Computer Science, and I'm handling computer architecture and organization in this art semester. Okay. So first, today what we are going to see is about what is mean by computer architecture and what is mean by organization, and also the components of the computer. What are the three main components of a computer? First, we will see about the definition or what is mean by computer architecture, because we have to understand the title of a subject. That is the most important thing. Then only we can understand the content of the subject. So what is a computer architecture? The architecture is those, that is the attributes of the computer which is visible to the programmer or visible to the programmer or to the user, is called as a computer architecture. So the attributes, for example, the instruction set, what kind of instructions that you are going to use. For example, for this program you are going to see the arithmetic instruction set, or the logical set, or the number of bits which are they are going to use. You are going to use 8 bits or 16 bits or 32 bits, or what kind of data representation, that is what kind of data types you are going to use, and what are the input and output mechanisms you are going to use, and what are the addressing techniques, what are the addressing modes. That is, we have in digital microprocessor, you would have learned about the types of addressing modes, the immediate, direct, indirect, and so on. So these are all visible to the programmer or visible to the user. So these are all the attributes, the normal or the attributes of a program. So these attributes are visible to the programmer or to the user, is called as computer architecture. Next, we will see the organization. As usual, it is the opposite of the architecture. The attributes in a computer are the features in a computer which are not visible to the programmer or the user, is called as a computer organization. And the main feature or the main activity of this organization is, what are all the architecture we have, the attributes we have, that architecture, that instruction set, that addressing modes will be implemented in organization. The architecture, we will not implement, that is, we will collect the information. In this organization, we will implement these, or we will execute those instructions that was collected by the architecture. So the features that are visible, not visible to the programmer, is a computer organization. So what are those? For example, what are the features? Means, for example, we have control signals, we have interfaces, we have memory technologies. For example, you can say we have here this the what you call as the radio signals, the cell phone tower signals, which are not visible to the user or the programmer. So those are the features that are not visible to the program. So the signals, the interfaces which are not visible to the programmer or the user, is called as a computer organization. For example, the interfaces means we can say a software, or we are using a software, or we are using an interface. We are used as the interfaces which are used in computer. So those are all things which are not visible to the programmer. And the next one is the most important thing, is the components of the computer. I think we know the computer is made up of what you called as a monitor, a CPU, and we have a keyboard and mouse and so on. But the main ingredient of a computer, or the main module of a computer, main modules of a computer are the memory, the I/O, that is the input and output, and the CPU, it is the brainchild of the computer, the central processing unit. So if these modules are communicate with each other, if there is a problem, there is a what you call as a connectivity problem in between these modules, means then there is a problem in our, that is the connectivity is not there. If the connectivity between these modules are not able to communicate with each other, means then we can say the computer is facing a major problem. So each one of these modules are important in order to execute a program, or read a program, or write a program in a computer. Or in the computer, we have read and write for the data instructions. The moon module is very important. Next, we will see First one is you will see memory module briefly. We will see just the outline of the memory module. The memory module is just like a human brain. The memory module is mainly used for storage of data storage, and we can copy the data in a memory, or we can take the data out there also. So the main activity, the operation of the memory module is to store data and the instruction. Okay. Next, we will see about the input and output module. The input and output module works as a mediator between the devices, the I/O devices. For example, we can say from if the memory module wants to transfer data from memory module to the processor, we need the input and output module. Okay, it provides an intermediate between one or more devices in order to communicate with the peripheral device. Even for a peripheral device, in order to communicate with the processor, we need the I/O device. So these are the structures of the I/O module. And the central processing unit, which is the main processor for our central processor, a main processor of any computer, it is a brainchild of a computer. It is mainly used for, or it is the purpose of the central processing unit is to execute instructions in a computer program. In the computer program analog, instructions execute, we need the CPU, the central processing unit. The central processing unit contains a lot of what you call as devices. In itself, we have interrupt signal bay. We have so many, we will see in the later videos. And in order to connect these modules, we have a pathway. That pathway is called as bus. We will call it as bus. Those parts are collectively known as interconnection structure. So thank you so much. And if you have any queries, means you can definitely mail us. Samuelk.kcs@gmail.com. Thank you.